everyone, welcome back. Today's video is different than usual. It's a get ready with me, chit chat. I basically just talk my way through it, answer a few of your questions, give you a few life updates on what's new with us and our family. So I hope you enjoy the video. And if you wanna see how to get this very low-key casual makeup everyday makeup look, then just keep watching. I was just filming for 5 minutes and realized I forgot to turn on the mic, so I have to start over. So before I start applying my makeup, I always apply sunscreen, and I've been loving this one from Dr. Dennis Gross because it's an SPF 50. I think this is like my fourth bottle, but I absolutely love it. And then after that, I apply the MAC Prep and Prime, literally the best primer I have ever used. And then I'm going to move into foundation. And I'm using the Light Wonder Youth Boosting Perfect Skin Foundation from Charlotte Tilbury. And I'm going to add just a tiny bit of the Wonder Glow just because I never use it. And I'm trying super hard to like use up all of my products before buying new ones. The reason why I was filming this is because I felt like I needed to update you guys on what's going on with me and my life. The biggest thing recently is that we moved, and we moved from Arizona to Utah. We lived in Arizona for about a year and a half. We lived in Utah before that, so we basically moved home. After the foundation, then I'm going to apply a concealer. So I'm going to use this Clarins Instant Concealer. This is in the shade 1. So the reason why we moved to Arizona in the first place is because my husband got a job as a flight instructor. He's trying to build his hours to be a professional pilot. He recently got a job as a cargo pilot, so he flies cargo for FedEx and UPS now, and so that's why we moved back to Utah. It's a better job. I mean, he's way happier, and I'm happy to be closer to family, so that's good. So next I'm gonna cream contour. This is a new thing that I've been doing, and I'm not very good at it yet, but what I did is I took my NARS Laguna bronzer, and I went to the store and I tried to find a concealer that matched that color. And so I have the NARS Creamy Concealer in the shade Medium Dark Chestnut. Also, I'm sorry if I'm giving any of you anxiety for not clipping my hair back. I can't stand it when people do their makeup without clipping their hair back, but if I clip my hair back and I film this whole video, I'm not gonna wanna post it because my hair looks so stupid. So I'm gonna leave it down and give all of you anxiety. So I'm just placing this everywhere that I would contour. And it dries so fast that you have to do it like section by section. My mom wanted me to do her makeup. Basically, we went to the store and spent almost $500 on makeup. And then she had me like show her how to do her makeup. And she refused to wear any powder at all. She's in her 50s. I think that's why, because like your skin just looks better if everything's cream. So everything we bought for her was cream, and this is what I did for her because she didn't want to buy a powder bronzer. Okay, somebody asked, how many minutes does it take me to do a hairstyle? I would guess between 20 and 30 minutes depending on the hairstyle. How can I have volume in my hair? It's so straight that if I try to do this, it will look awful. Okay, so my best advice if you have really flat hair is, one, you could blow it out. So when it's wet, if you blow dry it, that helps give the hair volume. If you can use like a thickening mousse at your roots, that helps provide lift. Curling it also helps. So like if you curl it and if it doesn't hold curl, then you can do the whole like where you spray it with hairspray, curl it, and then wrap it up and pin it and let it cool that way. It's a long process, but that will give your hair more volume. And then if you use a dry shampoo and then you back comb it, product helps a ton, and it's really just prep work. Prep work will help the hair have a tiny bit more volume. Okay, so moving on to my eyes, I am going to keep my eyes really simple. So I'm just gonna do a tiny bit of contour, and I just got this Naked Petite Heat. So I'm just going to take the shade Hot Spell, maybe Vibrant, depending on how much vibrate shows up. I'm just gonna use Hot Spell.
Daddy wants to change my diaper, but I'm poopy.
Dad's gonna change your diaper?
Yes. Daddy can do it.
Are you sure? Because I can just do it right now.
No, you're not doing it. Daddy can do it.
Okay, questions are rolling in. My son locked the door to our bedroom downstairs. He came in telling me the door was locked and he couldn't get into his bedroom. I don't know what he was talking about. And then he was saying he was poopy, so I had to change his diaper. I'm gonna do eyeliner next. I don't know where my eyeliner is. Maybe it's a sign. I'm not supposed to wear it. Oh, it's right there. This is just the Revlon Color Stay. I like this because I can smudge it. Okay, so I'm getting questions on that picture. who taught you to do hair? Nobody really did. I just kind of learned by watching other people. So like YouTube videos, like I've been to 2 hair classes, and then I just always, like I've always just tried it on myself. What is your favorite hairstyle? I like anything that looks really complicated and messy and yet like effortless. I don't know if that makes sense. So it's like big braids, big waves, really fancy texture, detailed updos. I don't think I have a favorite. I literally could look at hair all day, every day. Where do you get the inspiration to film all of your videos? This is a tricky question because I run out of ideas quite a lot. I follow a ton of hair accounts on Instagram, and then I will just screenshot stuff that like speaks out to me. Okay, so for mascara, I'm using really weird mascaras. This is the MAC Upward Lash, and I have 2 samples of this, so I'm just using it. And then I just got this one. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise. This is literally the best mascara in the whole world, but I can't use it by itself. I have to use it with something else for some reason. What are your favorite products for the summer heat to help with frizz and dry hair? So I would definitely say a moisturizer. Okay, start in the shower. So a moisturizing shampoo. And then when you get out, I would recommend using some kind of hair oil. I really like one from Kerastase. It's a leave-in conditioner. And then I also love the agave oil. I think it's just a hair oil, but it's agave. You can find it at Sephora online, I believe. I've had like 3 bottles of it. It's amazing. I would not recommend a firm hold hairspray because those tend to make the hair frizzy, at least me. Like when you brush it out, your hair just like puffs. My hair puffs up. Seriously, I hate it. It's the worst thing. If you cut down on heat styling, that helps too, because heat styling dries your hair out. So blow dry your hair less, curl your hair less. Watch, I'm like not even recording that whole time. How often do you film slash take hair pictures? Do you plan the styles in advance? You are one of my biggest inspirations. Thank you so much. I would say I film 3 days a week. Maybe. But I kind of base it off of what videos I need. And right now I have about 10 videos filmed. That's just kind of how I am. I always have like a bunch of videos filmed. Actually, right now I need Instagram pictures. Maybe tomorrow, maybe do 3 hairstyles and then take pictures. And then I'll have 3 pictures to post for Instagram. That's kind of how I do it. Do you have any tips / products you use to get the hair in your braids to lie smoothly? Yes. Okay. Let me think of what I gotta put on my face next. Takes so long to do your makeup when you have to talk. One thing that I use is called braid paste, and it's the Oscar Blandi braid paste. I actually hate it because it makes my hair really greasy after I do it. There is a Kenra product that I really want to get. I want to say it's 14 and it's like a pomade. It comes in like a little jar. If I ever make a trip to Ulta, I'm gonna buy it. But it's a pomade, and what you do is I usually put it on the back of my hand, and then I'll put my finger in it and go like this, and then you kind of just want to like go like that, and then you do the braid, and then as you go, like let's say you braid to here and then grab your comb and like comb this and then braid a little bit farther and then comb that down and then braid a little bit farther, and then when you get done, grab your hairspray and spray it and then go like this and then let it dry, and then you go through and like pull it, you know how you pull the edges? And then grab your hairspray and spray it again, and then go like that again. And then when you lay it and you pin it, then usually what I'll do is I'll spray it again, and then I'll like go like this with my finger and like lay down any hairs that's like sticking up. Okay, so let's move on to the next thing. I pre-filled in my brows before I started because I'm a cheater. I'm just using the Anastasia pomade in the shade Taupe. And I'm just gonna kind of fill them in. This is just the Maybelline Great Lash Clear Gel, clear mascara. This stuff is so affordable. I constantly use this. If I couldn't do any makeup ever, but I could choose 2 things, I would do my brows and my eyelashes. Those are the 2 that I can't not do. Okay, so I think I'm pretty much done. I'm gonna throw on some bronzer because I'm extra. This is the Urban Decay Beached Bronzer in the shade Sunkissed. Oh, as I throw it. Do I look like I'm beating my face? Sometimes when I edit these pictures or videos, I'm like beating my face with that makeup brush. I hate that. Next, I'm gonna do blush. This is the NARS liquid blush in Dolce Vita. I am obsessed with this and it's really hard to use. So I put it on my fingers and then I tap, tap, taparoo until it blends. I always put too much. Actually, I think this might be the right amount. Can you see it? If you could eat one food for the rest of your life, what would it be? And I've thought about this question a lot. The answer that I came up with is really lame, and I want to say it's potatoes, and the reason is because you can make so many different things with potatoes. Like, you can cream potatoes, you can fry potatoes, you can bake potatoes, you can make potatoes into a lot of different food. I think either way you're gonna get so sick of it. Okay, and then for highlighter, I'm going to use, this is the Becca Opal highlighter. We're gonna drop it like it's hot. And then I'm just gonna put this on the highlights. You need help? You're so cute. You're so cute. Oh, I gotta do lips. I have such a problem with lips. So most of the time I use Pillow Talk, the Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk lip liner and lipstick. It's the bomb. If you can get your hands on it, oh my gosh, buy it right now. It's the best. But that's downstairs and I don't want to go down there, so I'm just gonna use the MAC Dervish lip liner. This is like the one I constantly use. I use this all the time. And then for my lips, I'm just gonna use the Naked Urban Decay cream lipstick in the shade Naked. Nice and pinky. Now I'm gonna set everything with the MAC Fix Plus. I use a magnet to fan my face, and every time Cohen sees this, he tells me it's for the fridge. And he takes it and goes and puts it on the fridge. So I have to hide it from him. But I think that's it. I think I'm done. So let's outro. So that wraps up today's Q&A video. Be sure to let me know what you think of this type of video down below in the comment section. And if you want to see more videos like this one, or at least more often, make sure to click the thumbs up and be sure to subscribe. If you haven't yet, you can click my little picture right up here to subscribe. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you next time.